Hello everyone, and in this video I'm going to be talking about Disney Magical Dice, the Enchanted board game, which was closed down on the 27th of December of last year. So Netmarble put out a notice saying we would like to thank everyone for enjoying Disney Magical Dice, and that unfortunately Magical Dice will end its service, and that they deeply appreciate all the support shown to the game. And then they go on to explain the game's service termination schedule, and that even if the game's installed after termination, you'll no longer be able to play it. So they originally released the game on the 20th of April of 2016, and then in 2017 they brought it back with like a new build. And I started playing it on the 20th of October of that year, which is when I first found the game. And then since then I played the game actively, and really enjoyed playing it. I never recorded it for the channel because I wasn't sure how a board game would do on my channel. But if you would like to see any board games on my channel, such as something similar to this, or Cluedo, or Clue as it's also known, or Game of Life, or Jenga, or things like that, just let me know in the comments and I'll record some gameplay videos of those, because I play them a lot off camera, but I've never considered them like play through games from the channel really. So in this, just now, this is a tutorial that the game first put you in when you first started playing it. And for those of you that don't know what this game is, it's basically a Disney version of Monopoly, where you, the same thing goes, you've got to build buildings around the board, and you can upgrade them into landmarks, which are more or less like hotels in Monopoly. And if you can get colour combos, those rent prices of the properties go up. And you would either have to get free colour combos, bankrupt your opponent, or you could also win by getting four magical squares. And as you played on in the game, you got these chests which you could open, and you could get like items and upgrades towards your character. So as you can see here, these are all the characters that I've got in the game. So you've got the likes of Mickey Mouse, Donald Duck, Minnie Mouse, Peter Pan, Woody, which is on the left there, Buzz Lightyear, Zootopia. And then in the latest update, they added, before the service termination, they added like Coco characters such as Miguel and various boards over time to the game as well. So there's lots of different boards you could play from all, from various Disney films and you could also have your own custom dice. So my personal favourites were the Mickey dice, which is the ones here, and they gave the most luckiness. So luckiness would mean that when I'm trying to get a certain number on the dice, it would be more likely to receive that number that I want. So right now this is the second to last match that I did in the game before they terminated it.
Selecting order, you're going second.
And this is the board of Frozen, which everyone seemed to play, honestly. Like whenever I chose random, it would always be the frozen board.
Your turn.
But it's a great board, so I don't mind. So each board is not just only different as in backgrounds and different like property names, but they also have different things on them. So on this one, you can see on all sides of the board there's one space called Ice Path. So if you were to land on Ice Path, you would be able to travel to another Ice Path on the board, and that would make it more like a tactical approach to the game. So like if you wanted to upgrade a building on one side, or you wanted to get a colour come on one side or something like that, you could travel to that side of the board if you landed on Ice Path.
Double 12.
Yay, double 6. So here's the ice now. So I'm gonna connect it to the other one. So I only need to go to the right side. So that's why I went over to that way. And then it forms the ice path. And then you go down. And the further you go around the board, like in Monopoly, the more expensive the properties are. And the X freeze on the board and means that if you purchase property on those, they are worth more than the original price it would normally be if it wasn't rent increased on those spaces.
Three.
Now this first game I decided to play as Woody because I unlocked him just before the service termination.
Five.
And so I wanted to play him before they closed down the service, but my main characters were like Olaf from Frozen and then Miguel from Miguel from Coco. And then there was another character from Coco as well, if I can remember his name. I think it was Hector. Yep, Hector was also in the game.
Your turn.
So as you can see here, I'm currently in second place because my opponent has more properties than me, so as a result has more property value.
Nine.
But at the same time, if you spend too much, then you might not be able to afford them.
Your turn.
Games are quite long, which is why I've only decided to show the last two games that I played.
Nine. Your turn.
But there was a lot of replay value in the game because not every game was identical, and some opponents were like were quite tough to beat, and some like you could win a few turns if you were lucky, of course, because sometimes luck is involved in this game. Sometimes you might be winning for 1 minute and then the next minute you land on their expensive property and then you've got to pay the price and possibly get out of it. And as for the game's termination, I could see why it was coming really, because towards the end of the game, not many people seem to have played it, particularly when they removed the game from the app stores before the game was even terminated. So as a result, it did take some time to find people for matches. And even 2v2, which is another mode that I used to play a lot, no one was like playing it really. It took a lot to find them, so I don't know what I thought you would be there all the time.
Landmark complete. Your turn. Nine. Eleven.
Oh, and the space my opponent's just done is the arcade, so each arcade game was different, so in this one you've gotta try and throw the snowball in the right direction to hands. And it's one of those like risk games, so like if you feel like you can do it a few times in a row, you can keep going, but you can like stop at a certain point and then collect your coins from that. But that's always fun. So like in the Mickey and Friends board, it would be like a football game with Pluto, which is Mickey Mouse's dog, and then put the dog friend, and then you just have to kick it in the right direction three times, and then you get the more
fortune card.
Doing that. And of course, fortune cards are your chance cards, more or less. So that like, you can sweep the most expensive building, or you can get
your turn.
Cards where you can donate coins to the last player, like everyone gets to donate coins to the last player. And if you're at the start, you can upgrade your like buildings, and they have to pay more of them as a result, like Monopoly really.
Six.
Oh, and that sled on the board, you can see, is also something unique to this board, because if you land on that, you can move the opponent who's on this, if they're on the same path as the sled, to the space that land on. So if I landed on that landmark just now, and if the sled was there, and she was, and my opponent was on the that side, then they would just like land on that. Probably like, the side's like moving them over to there. So that's always handy.
Your turn complete.
You could also upgrade characters so that they got certain traits. So like Jessie from Toy Story, she could like magnet people to her, so like if she landed somewhere on a property and I was three spaces away from her, then she could just drag me to her space.
Six.
And then I'd have to pay that price of the property that
your turn
they put landed on. Or like
11.
Some characters can increase property value if they go around the board. Oh yeah, and there's also a line combo that you can get as well. So technically there's four ways you can win the line combo as well. But I never really got the line combo so much. That's one of my items, so that basically means if I land somewhere, I don't always have to pay it.
Nine. Landmark complete. Select a square.
Then I've just like doubled the property, but not only was this game just playing this mode, there was also like Saga, which is like a single player mode against comms, and you would have or bots, and you would have to like do certain missions such as get color combos or winning the arcade, and then if you did all the challenges you get like 3 stars, and you get like gifts such as like card packs, and card packs add to your character, so you can level them up. They're like character upgrades, and the more you level them up, the better they become.
Just a few turns left. 6.
I was thinking just to record the last game that I did, but then I decided,
your turn.
Since I lost the last one of the game.
Double 10.
I thought I would, you know, showcase both sides, so not just me.
Your turn.
Not just me, like losing but winning as well.
10. Landmark complete. Fortune card. Select a square to attack.
Even though 20 minutes is, depending on what happens in the game, can still take a bit of time. It's nothing compared to the Monopoly, honestly. The actual Monopoly can take hours.
Landmark complete.
But
your turn.
This one was like 20 minutes per match, so you could play about at least 2 or 4, or maybe more, depending on how much time you have. Sometimes the games don't last that long if you can get a color combo or you bankrupt your opponent.
You got a square.
Because there is things in this that Monopoly doesn't have, such as like buffs, so you can like make things more
landmark complete. Running out.
So that's always handy.
7.
Some opponents are just like, I just
your turn. 5.
And it works the same in 2v2. It's the same rules in that, you know, you have to get line combos, color combos.
Close game.
And I mean, I lost this game because I couldn't get color combos or any properties, so it didn't go in my favor this one. So as you can see, you lose trophies, which go towards your rank, but you still get a bit of gold, experience points, and a prize chest. And you can add people as friends, and then if you added them, you could go into 2v2 together. So these are the board that I'm showing now. So you get Frozen, Mickey Mouse, Mickey Friends, Toy Story, stuff like that. What that are from all the Disney worlds. And each board had like a guide to them, because each board was like different, had different like
game start,
different things in each one. So like in the Toy Story one, there was like these cranes from like the prize grab arcade machines. So you could like lift squares to stop someone from going any further, and then they would have no choice but to stop on the space they would landed on. So usually you'd put it just after your property, so they land there, or you could also use them to build other squares on the board. I would have liked to showcase more boards in this, but honestly everyone just plays the Frozen board, so that's why both of these matches are on Frozen. But it's a great board, and you know, I love the music in this game as well. It's just very, very Disney, music, and it's just nice to listen to whilst you're playing the game, really. That's the card I was talking about, charity event. So now she has to donate some money to me. But yeah, it is a shame that the game got shut down, honestly. I really enjoyed playing it, and I was aiming to get to level 50 before the service ended, but as a result It didn't happen because not many people played it for me to get the experience points. But there is still similar games such as Game of Dice, which is similar to this, but you have like cards you can use that change the game. So like, it makes it more tactical, so it makes it a bit more in-depth, but at the same time, it's still Monopoly. That's like a card game, it's Monopoly more or less. So like, you could use cards to gain more properties, and you can like get properties just by passing people, or you can summon them to the space you're on. And that game is still up as we speak, so if you'd like to see a Game of Dice to the channel, then let me know. And there's also one that's more traditional Monopoly called Business Tour, which is where you, instead of buying like cities and stuff, you buy like country names such as like Berlin. So it's like it's like country names around the board, but again, it's still, it's like Monopoly. So I wouldn't mind paying that for a channel. And then I also played something called Cluedo, as I was mentioning before, or Clue, depending on how you call it. And that's always really fun to play as well. The games usually only last about 15 to 15 minutes, so it's not bad really. I haven't tried the Jenga game yet though. And that's for Game of Life, no one seems to put it online, which is a shame, but again, Game of Life is quite a long game, so I might not record that for the channel, but if there's any board games you'd like to see, as I say, just let me know, and I would be willing to play any of them, honestly. But I never recorded this game because, like, I know Disney's popular, but I didn't know how a board game would do on my channel, because, like, it would just be on this board, and then it's still the same rules and the same format, just with like different events on each mode. So I wasn't sure how that would do on my channel, as I've never recorded anything Disney on my channel before, or a board game for that matter. So Troll Folly is basically where you just move to another space on the board, so like your world tour space, as it's called in Business Tour. But yes, I would be up for any board game, honestly. I wouldn't mind playing any of them. I'd still do my playthroughs and acting if it does as well, but if anyone wanted to see them anymore, then I wouldn't mind doing them. But I've still got other videos planned for the channel as well, so plenty of content to be going for 2019, that's for sure. And as for this game, I can see why it was shut down, to be honest. It's like, it was lacking players, and possibly people weren't paying for the DLC packs, which keeps the game going. I mean, I personally didn't see the need to buy anything in this game. There was no pay-to-play elements. There was nothing that convinced me to pay for the game, because I was okay just playing it free. And considering it's, you know, it's a good thing really, because it's very annoying when you like put money into a game and then they shut it down and they don't even give you a refund, because of course you apparently agreed to like not expecting a refund, more or less. So like, if you accept the terms and you buy stuff, then you're like accepting that whatever money you put into the game, you can't get back basically. But luckily, I didn't put any money into this game. It used to be completely different back in 2016 though. It was like you played as like these smaller characters dressed up as the Disney characters. So like, you wouldn't play as the actual Disney character, you would just play as a character who's dressed up like them. But I never played that version, because the version that I play, which is this one, they had already had all these this like these new characters in the game. And to be honest, I can see why they updated it, because they wanted it so you could play as the actual character rather than a character dressed up as them. I mean, some people preferred the old game, but I couldn't really sell on that one because I never played it. Because they ruined that, it was shut down back then, and then they opened it again for this new version. Not to say they could bring it back again, but to be honest, I can't see that happening 3 years on the run. But they did say that they're going to try and make more games, so we'd have to see. And I know they've got a Marvel game from the same company, Netmarble, so again, if you want to see Marvel, I think called Marvel Future Fight, if you want to see that on the channel, I wouldn't mind recording that either. But I've never actually played Marvel much, honestly, so I probably wouldn't be the best at it, but I would give it a go, nonetheless. I also might record some rhythm games, because there's a rhythm game that I've had for a while called Love Beat Anytime, which is more or less Love Beat as I record normally, but it's like similar to a bit like Touch, and also has the classic mode that with the arrows. And some people do play it, and it's a nice game really. It's not too hard to get the hang of, and it's really nice to play, so that's always fun. And speaking of Love Beat, I've also got an anniversary video coming up, so that will be coming as well. And then as this match was so long, I had to record it in two parts. So that might be why there's a slight cut there, but I managed to record it nonetheless. Because I was playing this on something called BlueStacks, which is a PC emulator, but as a result, some reason my recording software that I used for like Okami wasn't working with this for some reason. Don't know, I lost that game as well. But I did win the first two. I might show like a little video of me winning one game that I played. But I didn't want to like showcase all of the videos because it would take too long, it would be like a 40 minute video otherwise. So now when you try to load the game, it will show this loading screen as it normally does, and it will say connecting to the server. But after a minute or two, but if I thought to end the video,
your turn.
I would end on a high and show the game that I won, which is the first match of four. I still record match two as a separate video. Let me know if you want to end the video.
Your turn.
And it is, and do that. But I thought I would include it in this because it would otherwise be a 40-minute video, as I said before, and I wanted it to be about 20
landmark complete
minutes to half an hour, who knows. But nine. I like to showcase the game to its full, really. I don't want to do snippets, so
your turn. Fantastic.
That's why it's a half hour video, so last
year.
It's a shame that the game got down, because I really enjoy playing it and it was a lot of fun. But they might bring it back, who knows.
Six.
I know this one doesn't make a condensed play, so if you want to see that, I'll let it out.
Wow!
But for today, that might be the video.